Elsewhere in the Pacific, at exactly the same time, Megan Alikli goes about her job of launching a balloon from the arm site in Nauru. Where Manus is a fairly large island, Nauru is just a small dot in the huge ocean. The Nauru arm site is located on the western side of the island and has been in operation since late 1998. This site has the same scientific instruments as Manus, and Megan is one of the local observers. Observing weather is a 24-hour operation.
We have shift work, so maybe I work today in the morning, so I don't work in the afternoon, but I come back after for balloon launching at nighttime.
In Nauru, the balloons are filled with hydrogen. This is cheaper than helium, but because of the danger of explosion, the observer cannot fill the balloon by hand or be near the balloon. Therefore, a remote launching system has been installed.
I'll come and prepare myself for balloon launching, fill up balloon, and then launch.
The night launch of balloons is just as important. This balloon was fitted with a light, so it is easier to follow with the camera. Inside the computer van, the data is received and checked by Megan. The stations are constantly being improved and developed.
We're going to try to get some trenches put in here so we can put in a water line, a power line, and then the hydrogen gas line for launching balloons.
In Manus, they're preparing to install a remote balloon launcher similar to the one in Nauru. A variety of instruments on the site collect information about clouds. How much of the sky is covered by cloud? How low or high is the cloud, and what type of cloud is it? How much water does the cloud hold? How much of the sun's radiation does it block out? The scientists need answers to these and other questions to fully understand the significance of clouds in the global climate system.
This instrument is called the WSI, the All Sky Imager.
Every 10 minutes, the camera inside the instrument takes a new picture of the sky. The specially designed so-called fisheye lens enables the camera to see the whole sky all around the horizon. Inside the van, a purpose-built computer displays the current picture of the sky and clouds.
This is the picture taken by the WSI, and as you can see, there is Mary, myself, and a cameraman. For this shot, we were able to be on the screen because we were next to the WSI camera. In the next few seconds, we will see another image. The cameraman, myself, and Mary will no longer be there. As you can see, this is what happened after 10 minutes. These are clouds. There's a couple of instruments. Myself, Mary, and the cameraman no longer are there.
The images are stored on computer and uplinked to the researchers in the United States. Another instrument used to look at clouds is the ceilometer. Its function is to constantly measure the bottom altitude of the clouds. It sends a laser beam straight up into the sky and then measures how long it takes for the laser to be reflected back. Computers store the data and produce graphic timeline images of the clouds during the day and night. The microwave water vapor radiometer also looks into the sky.
It measures water vapor and water droplets.
The measurements are taken from the surface to the top of the atmosphere. We often say it is humid in tropical countries. This is because there is a lot of water vapor in the air. For every square meter of land and sea in the tropics, there is approximately 60 liters of water vapor in the air, something like four buckets of water. This is about 60,000 tons of pure water per square kilometer of islands and ocean, almost 20 times the capacity of this fuel tanker. Yet we can't even see it because it is spread so thinly out between the Earth's surface and high in the atmosphere. Water vapor is a very important factor in climate research because it absorbs both solar and terrestrial radiation. A whole series of instruments detect solar radiation.
This instrument is called the PSP. This one actually measures all the radiation that comes from the sky. Total radiation that comes from the sky. If it's cloudy, then there's not so much radiation coming through. This particular instrument measures all that. This instrument over here is the PIR. It measures the heat radiation that comes from the sun. This instrument here is the UVB, the ultraviolet biometer. It measures the ultraviolet rays that come from the sun.
Another instrument measures radiation from the whole sky except the sun. Two small shades block direct sunlight from getting to the sensors. This instrument, on the other hand, looks only at the sun.
It measures radiation directly from the sun. It's pointed directly at the sun and measures whatever radiation that comes straight from the sun on it.
A series of similar instruments look down on the ground, measuring reflection and radiation from the surface. The ARM program is not only doing research in the tropical Western Pacific. There is another ARM climate research station in the Arctic under freezing conditions in Alaska. The same instruments are in operation, measuring clouds and radiation in the Arctic region. The biggest research station is in the southern Great Plains of the United States, where instruments have been spread out over 40,000 square kilometers. The ARM project activities in the Pacific are carried out in collaboration with the South Pacific Regional Environment Program, SPREP.
The South Pacific Regional Environment Program has been given a mandate by the 26 of its member countries to coordinate and facilitate all the climate change and climate activities and, of course, meteorological services activities in the tropical Western Pacific. So we've been involved in ensuring that the program not only meets the goals and objectives that are set out under the ARM program for their own needs, but also meets the needs of individual countries, SPREP member countries that are involved in the program.
ARM is making an important contribution to the weather forecasting services in the region.
Currently, this ARM site is providing the National Weather Service with the upper air observations, and this is the only upper air observation stations in the region or in this part of the world, apart from the other sites that are not operational at the moment. So the data that we receive through this site assists our weather forecasters in weather forecasts.
In addition, we're just putting up the forecast now this week for the first time for the people of Nauru, which was not available before. So you can see a lot of the benefits directly to the people of what this sort of program is all about.
The ARM program has also helped with the development of a new school curriculum about climate change and held workshops for teachers in both Papua New Guinea and Nauru.
The students need to know, you know, about issues that affect their lives, and with the climate change, and the sea level rise, it's very relevant to their needs here on Nauru, because we have experience going through these droughts and the El Nino effect.